on. It makes me feel like a little fairy queen.
But you're already in bloom.
Now, shh. You've made me forget all our good news. Just imagine, Ventla. Last night, the stork finally visited your sister, brought her another little baby girl.
Oh, I can't wait to see her, Mama.
Then go put on a proper dress and take a hat.
Mama, don't be cross. Don't be. But I'm an aunt for the second time now, and I still have no idea how it happens. Mama, please, I'm ashamed to even ask. But then, who can I ask but you?
Oh, Ventla Bergen, you cannot imagine that I
could... cannot imagine. I still believe in the stork.
I don't know what I've done to deserve this kind of talk. And on a day like today, go, child, put your clothes on.
And if I run out now and ask Gregor, our chimney sweep?
Very well. I'll tell you everything, but not today. Tomorrow or the day after.
Today, Mama.
Then to the Bergen, I simply...
Mama!
You will drive me mad.
Why? Kneel at your feet, lay my head in your lap. You can talk as if I weren't even here. Please.
Very well, I'll tell you.
Yes?
Child, I...
Mama.
All right, then. In order for a woman to conceive a child, you follow me?
Yes, Mama.
In order for a woman to bear a child, she must, in her own special way, she must love her husband. Love him as she can love only him. Only him. She must love him with her whole heart.
There. Now you know everything. Everything.
Everything. So help me.
Mama!
Mama who bore me. Mama who gave me. Mama the angel.
Labinaque veni litorae.
Archivo! Archivo!
Sir!
Continue! Please! Archivo!
Labinaque venit.
Yes.
Litora multum enim.
Multum enim.
Multum olim.
Olim! Multum olim! So then somehow pious Aeneas has already suffered much in the days still to come. Herr Schieffel, do you have any idea what you're saying, Herr Schieffel?
If you please.
Pardon me.
If you please, Erzlaminstich, can't we at least consider multum olim as a plausible conjecture for how the text might read?
Herr Gabor, we are hardly here today to conjecture about textual conjecture. The boy has made an error.
Yes, but an understandable error, sir. Indeed, if we could only entertain the fitness of the conjecture.
Multum olim.
Look to the fresh rhetorical balance. Multum olim introducing multa quoque. A parallel, sir, between what Aeneas has already suffered in war and those sufferings on land and sea just ahead.
Ergo bore, since the days of Servius, Alus Gellius, and Claudius Donatus, nay, since the moment of Virgil's death, our world has been littered with more than sufficient critical commentary on textual conjecture.
With all due respect, sir, are you then suggesting there is no further room for critical thought or interpretation? Why, indeed, then, do we
I am suggesting no such thing! I am confirming that Herr Stiefel has made an error, and I am asking, nay, demanding that you amend his faulty text and proceed from there! Do I make myself clear? Herr Gabor! Herr Gabor, do I make myself clear?
Yes, Erzomenstich. Litura multum ile.
All of you, together with Melchior Gabor, Babinacque, venit.
Litura multum ile, et teris iactatus et alto, vi superum saevae memorem unonis.
All that's known. Thought is suspect, and money is their idol, and nothing is okay unless it's scripted in their Bible. I know there's so much more to find, just in looking through myself and not at them. Still I know to trust my own true mind and to say the way through us. On I go. Child feels for everything you show. You watch me, just watch me. I'm calling, one day all alone. You watch me, just watch me.
The following seven lines from the pious Aeneas' journey, from memory.
Nothing. Thank you.
It's nothing.
Still, I'm sorry. You didn't have
to. Think what Aeneas suffered.
But I should have known it. Multum ile. It's just, I didn't sleep all night. In fact, I suffered a visit from the most horrible dark phantasm.
You mean a dream?
A nightmare, really. Legs in sky blue stockings, climbing over the lecture podium.
Oh, that kind of dream.
Have you ever suffered such mortifying visions?
Moritz, of course. We all have. Otto Lammermeier dreamt about his mother.
Really?
Georg Sechnitz dreamt he was seduced by his piano teacher.
Fräulein Klausen Wüstenhalter?
Moritz Stiefel! I need hardly remind you that of all of our pupils, you are in no position to be taking liberties. I will not warn you again.
God, I dreamed there was an angel who could hear me through the wall. So I cried out loud and laughed, and so not like a ball. Tell me not how I was met there, and I heard you say it all. She said, just keep trying, kid, and I want it all. She said, give me that hand, please, so that you can control. I'm gonna teach you how to handle all the sadness in your soul. Oh, I love that so magic, and I'm aiming at the wall. She said, love me, girl.
Some dark part of my destiny may lie there between them.
All right, I'll tell you. I got it out of books, but prepare yourself. It made an atheist of me. So.
No, 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 not here, no. I can't talk it, no. Do me a favor. Write it down, all of it. Conceal it in my satchel tomorrow after gymnastics. If you like, you could leave some illustrations in the margins.
Top to bottom?
Everything.
Unfathomable, Fraulein Knippledick.
Air Knippledick.
Look at that. Melchior Gabor. A young man of distinct intellectual capability.
Thoroughly distinct.
A young man who could be our finest pupil.
Our finest, Air Knippledick.
But there he is. Himself, cavorting about that
neurasthenic imbecile, Morge Stiefel.
Thank heaven the upper grade only holds 60.
And the bodice, all in lace. Where does that go in the back?
And Bempa, well, we were to Greta Brandenburg's wedding.
Mama said we cannot go.
To Greta's wedding? Because she's marrying the forest inspector?
Mama felt it was a little improper.
But they're decking the entire sanctuary out in orchids and chrysanthemums.
Mama said no.
Well, I sure hope your mama approves the man I marry.
And the man I marry.
Well, we all know Kale wants to marry.
Now, you're before.
And who doesn't?
He is rather handsome.
So wonderful.
But not so wonderful as the sad, silver, sleepyhead Morris.
Moritz Stiefel? How can you even compare them?
Melchi Gabor, he is such a radical.
You know what the whisper is? He doesn't believe in anything. Not in God, not in heaven, not in a single thing in this world.
They say he's the best in everything. Latin, Greek, trigonometry.
And the best part is, he doesn't care a whit about any of it.
In the midst of this nothing, this mess of life, still there's this one thing just to see you go by.
It's almost like loving, sad as that is.
May not be cool, but it's so where I live.
It's like I'm your lover, or more like your ghost. I spend the day wondering what you do and where you go.
I try and just kick it, but then what can I do? We've all got our junk, and my junk is you.
See us winter walking after a storm. It's chill in the wind, but it's warm in your arms. The star goes so long, may not be true. We've all got our junk, and my junk is you.
Well done, Georg. And now the prelude in C minor.
Have you prayed tonight, Desdemona? You don't look like you're praying, darling. Lying there, contemplating the coming bliss. Anjan, are you all right? My stomach again, father, but I'll be fine.
Yes.
Fine.
Well then.
Darling, don't think I take your murder lightly. The truth is, I can hardly bear to think of the long nights ahead. Sucking the marrow from my bones, seeing you lying there motionless. One of us must go, it's you or me.
Oh, no, no, Georg, again, please, and this time, bring out the left hand.
Okay. Darling, why? Why do you press your knees together? Even now, on the brink of eternity, don't you see it's your terrible chastity that's driving me to.
Anjan, that's enough in there.
Yes, sir.
Back to bed.
Done.
1 minute! One last kiss. Those soft red eyes, those girlish breasts, oh, those blue, cruel knees!
Repente, Steve, who play!
Will you have to excuse me? I know it's so well. When you did stuff, it's ruined and so long. I go up to my room, turn the stereo on, shoot up some music.
Couples with the stallion? Are they deaf to everything their loins are telling them until we grant them a marriage certificate? I think not. To my mind, shame is nothing but a product of education. Meanwhile, old Father Kaulbach still blindly insists in every single sermon that it is deeply rooted in our sinful human nature. Which is why I now refuse to go to church.
Melchior!
Yes, Mama?
Marit Stiefel to see you.
I'm sorry, I'm so late. I yanked on a jacket, ran a brush through my hair, and dashed like some phantom to get here.
You slept through the day.
I'm exhausted, Melky. I stayed up all night reading that essay you gave me till I couldn't see straight.
Sit. Let me roll you a smoke.
Look at me. I'm trembling. Last night, even, I prayed like Christ in Gethsemane. Dear God, give me consumption and take these sticky dreams away from me.
With any luck, that's a prayer he'll ignore.
Melky, I can't focus on anything. Well, even now, it seems, well, I see and I hear and I feel quite clearly that everything else seems so strange.
But what about those illustrations I gave you? Didn't they help to illuminate your dreams?
They only multiplied everything 10 times. Now instead of merely seeing stockings, I'm plagued by Lady Amajora and...
Well, here we are!
Very well, thank you, Father Boy.
Just think, Mama. Moritz was up reading through the night.
Conjugating Greek.
You must take care of yourself, Moritz. Surely your health is more important than ancient Greek. And what have you been reading, Melchior?
Goethe's Faust, actually.
Really? At your age?
It's so beautiful, Mama.
So haunting.
Still, I should have thought. But surely you boys are now of an age where you can decide for yourselves what is good and what is not. If you need anything, children, call me.
Well,
your mother certainly is remarkable.
Until she catches her son reading Goethe.
I think she meant the story of Gretchen and her illegitimate child.
Yes, you see how obsessively everyone fixes on that story. Which is if the whole world were mesmerized by penis and vagina.
Well, I am. All the more so, I'm afraid, since reading your essay. This part here, is it true?
Absolutely.
But how can you understand that, Melky? What the woman must feel?
Giving yourself over to someone. Defending yourself until finally you surrender and feel heaven break over you. I just put myself in her place and imagine.
Really? What it feels for the woman.
When I go there, no more memory anymore. Only drifting on some ship, the wind that whispers of the distance.
No more weeping.
the Bergman. Like tree men fallen from the branches. What are you doing alone up here?
Mama's making May wine. I thought I'd surprise her with some woodruff. And you?
This is my favorite spot. My private place for thinking.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, no. No, please. So, how have you been?
Well, this morning was wonderful. Our youth group brought baskets of food and clothing to the day laborers' children.
I remember when we used to do that, together.
You should have seen their faces, Melchior. How much we brightened their day.
Actually, it's something I've been thinking a lot about.
The day laborers?
Our little acts of charity. What do you think, Fenda? Can our Sunday school deeds really make a difference?
They have to. Of course. What other hope do those people have?
I don't know exactly, but I fear that industry is fast determining itself firmly against them.
Against us all, then.
Thank you, yes.
Seems to me what serves each of us best is what serves all of us best.
Indeed. Fendel Bergman, I have known you all these years, and yet we've never truly talked.
We have so few opportunities now that we're older.
True. In a more progressive world, of course, we could all attend the same school, boys and girls together. Wouldn't that be remarkable?
What time is it?
Must be close to 4.
Oh, I thought it was later. I paused and lay in the moss by the stream so long and just let myself dream. I thought it must be later.
Then can't you stay and sit for a moment? When you lie back against this oak tree and stare up at the clouds, you start to think hypnotic things.
I have to be back before 5.
But when you lie here, such a strange, wonderful peace settles over you.
Well, for a moment, maybe. Just to unreal all this. Watching the words fall from my lips.
Oh, you cannot be mine. 10 minutes.
Thank God.
But you're trembling.
For joy. For pure and certain joy.
Cross your heart.
Twice over.
Oh, Melchior.
Moritz, I've been looking for you. Where have you been?
He's stuck into the headmaster's office.
Moritz, what were you thinking?
I had to, Melchior. I just had to. The good news is I passed.
The middle terms, that is.
Exactly. Everything will now be determined by the final exams. Still, I know I passed. Truly, heaven must feel like this.
Well, well, Fraulein Knubeldick.
Melkenbrook?
Now that skittish near-phasic moron...
Lord Stiefel?
...has somehow passed our middle-term exams, but it appears we face a certain dilemma.
Ah.
Upper grade, as we know, will only hold 60. I hardly think we can promote 61.
Hardly, Melkenbrook, but... Let us look to the finals ahead.
Yes.
Remember, it is I who shall be grading them.
Then I am assured the good name of our school is secure.
Shall we take a short way home?
No, no, by the bridge!
After 2 hours marching through that medicine ball?
Come on!
Someone wants to sleep. Has Melchior the board taken his raft out?
Last one there has the whole hand of Hanshin!
Oh, Marcy, careful, you're breaking in this. No.
Just let it. Isn't it a nuisance day in and day out? You may not cut it short, you may not wear it down.
Tomorrow I'm bringing scissors.
Because I'm sick, Bella, no! Papa beats me enough as it is.
Marta, where are your friends?
Well, they don't do as he likes.
What?
Some nights Papa yanks out his belt.
But where is your mama?
We have rules in this house. Your father will not be disobeyed. The other night I ran for the door. Out the door? All right, I like that. That's where you'll spend the night. Out on the street.
No. It was so cold.
Oh my God.
He beats you with a belt? With a buckle?
Right there.
Oh my God! Marta, the welts, they're terrible!
We must tell someone.
Anna, no.
We must?
No. Please. They'll throw me out for good.
Like what happened to Ilsa, you mean?
Remember, still.
Anna, no. Just look at what's become of Ilsa now. Sleeping who knows where with who knows who.
I just wish I could somehow go through it for you.
My Uncle Klaus says if you don't discipline a child, you don't love it.
That must be.
When I have children, I'll let them be free. And they'll grow up strong and tall.
Free? But how would we know what to do if our parents don't tell us?
Marta, time for bed now.
There's part I can't tell about the dark. I know well.
Marta, darling, go put on that new nightgown, the pretty ruffled one your father bought you.
You say, time for bed now, child. Mom smiles that smile, just like she never saw me. Just like she never saw me. So I leave one just like no day inside. You are coming to me. You are coming to me. You said all you want is just a kiss. Good night, and you hold me, and you whisper, "Child, the world will find you."
27th, November. The trouble is, the terrible prerogative of the parentocracy in secondary education.
Herr Stiefel, may we have a word with you?
A world where teachers, like parents, view us as merely so much raw material for an obedient and productive society. A unified, military-like body, where all that is weak must be hammered away. Where the progress of the students reflects back only on the rank and order of the faculty. And therefore, a single low mark can be seen as a threat to the entire system. You.
I was lying by the stream and then I saw you.
Yes, well.
So,
the stream. Dreaming again.
I was, I guess.
What were you dreaming of?
It's silly.
Tell me.
I dreamed I was a clumsy little girl who spilled her father's coffee. And when he saw what I had done, he yanked out his belt and he whipped me.
Then that kind of thing doesn't happen anymore. Only in stories.
Marta Bessel is beaten almost every evening. The next day, you can see the welt. It's terrible. Really, it makes you boiling hot to hear her tell it. Well, lately, I can't think of anything else.
Someone should file a complaint.
You know, I've never been beaten before. Not once. I can't even imagine it. It must be just awful.
I don't believe anyone is ever better for it.
I've tried hitting myself. Find out how it feels, really, inside. With this switch, for example, it's tough and thin.
Draw blood?
You mean if you beat me with it?
Beat you?
Me.
Fenfa, what are you thinking?
Nothing.
Never beat you.
But if I let you?
Never.
But if I asked you to?
Are you out of your mind?
Marta Bessel, she told Fenfa, me that.
You can't envy someone being beaten.
But I've never been beaten. My entire life, I've never felt.
What?
Anything. Please, no cure. I don't feel it.
Maybe not under your dress.
On my legs, then.
Fenfa.
Come on. Please.
I'll teach you to say please.
You're barely stroking me.
What's that, then?
Martin's father, he uses his belt. He draws blood, Melky.
What's that?
Nothing!
You bitch! I'll beat the hell out of you!
No!
One day, if I failed, You're telling them you failed.
No, no, I only meant that.
You failed, haven't you? I can see it on your face.
Father, no! Father, please!
It's finally come to this. I can't say I'm surprised. My son failed. What are your mother and I supposed to do? You tell me, son, what? How can she show her face at the Missionary Society? What do I tell them at the bank? How do we go to church? My son failed. Failed! Thank God my father never lived to see this day.
Dear Herr Stiefel, Moritz, I've spent the entire day thinking about your note. Truly, it touched me and did that you'd think of me as a friend. Of course, I was saddened to hear that your exams came off rather less well than you hoped, and that you will not be promoted come fall. And yet, I must say straight away that fleeing to America is hardly the option. And even if it were, I cannot provide the money you request.
Ha ha ha, well fine, not like it's even worth the time. Still you know, you wanted more. Sorry if the change's been there before.
You would do me wrong, Herr Stiefel, to read into my refusal any lack of affection. On the contrary, I truly believe it to be my duty as well as mine.
Take that stuff's okay for me. $1,000 of life's got free, and I mean please, that's all I need. You're real okay, by now you know the score.
Should you like, I am ready to write to your parents. I will try and convince them that no one could have worked love losses in their son, and that all the rigorous a condemnation of your partner's fortune
would have... What a laugh, it's too absurd. Okay, so now we do the play. Act like we don't care, no way. You're right, my folks, we'll okay. Babe, that's how it goes.
My dear boy, the world is full of men, businessmen, scientists, scholars even, who have done rather poorly in school and yet gone on to have brilliant careers. Consider, for example, the
they're best. Not my home, not anymore.
So...
can't see it sulking in some hayloft.
Out!
Everyone's at church, rehearsing for our Christingle chorale. I slipped out.
Yes, what?
Your friend Moore Stiefel's absent. Someone said he's been missing all day.
I expect he's had his fill of Christingle.
Perhaps. You know, I have your journal.
You too?
You left it the other day. I confess, I tried to-
Please, just leave it.
Melchior, I'm sorry about what happened. Truly, I am. I understand why you'd be angry at me. I don't know what I was thinking.
Don't.
How can I not?
Please, don't. We were confused. We were both just...
Yes, but it was my fault that...
No, please, don't. It was me. All me. Something in me started when I hit you.
Something in me, too.
I hurt you.
Yes, but still.
No more. No more, my God. Just please. You should go.
Won't you come out to the meadow now, Melchior? It's dark in here and stuffy. I can run through the rain. Soaked to the skin and not even care.
Forgive me.
It was me. It was all me.
I can hear your heartbeat, Fenton.
Oh, Milky, I don't know.
No matter where I go, I hear it beating.
And I hear yours.
Supposed to what? Love? I don't know. Is there such a thing? I hear your heart. I feel you breathing everywhere. The rain, the hay.
No.